Well, well, well. Look who finally showed up. Not me. I swear to God, this mic's gonna like fall off soon. It just feels like it's not securely attached. But hey, howdy. What's happening? A little late start for the night, but you know, that's how it goes sometimes. We're gonna do some more System Shock runs. I'm going to try out these potentially better spots for Out of Bounds I found last night. See if they're actually better. See if they actually work, I should say. Then we'll probably do some Amnesia stuff and go from there. That's the plan. Oh my god, planning out streams. Whoa. I feel like I don't have something up and running that neat. I got a live split, I got my alerts, I got this open. I think I'm good. I just feel like I'm forgetting something. I just feel like perhaps I've forgotten something, you know? Have I forgotten anything? I don't think so. I think it's just because I started the stream late that I'm just like freaking out. I think we're fine. I think so. I don't know. I'm gonna be honest. I'm sure in like 2 hours from now, I'm gonna be like, oh, I meant to do this thing. Or as the stream comes to an end, I'm like, ah, I forgot. Forgot to have a nice sip of water. Start the bot. Yeah, bot's up. Bot's always running. The only time the bot goes down is if my PC like restarts. I need to fix some stuff on Bot Thunder, but that's a different story altogether. Yo, Vibos, what's up? I think I may know what I'm thinking of, but it's not gonna matter until tomorrow anyways. Okay. Yeah, I just never made my my PB from last night for this game public, but, you know, we might just beat it tonight anyway, so. Yeah, it's fine. I like how much the background changes here. It's kind of fun to watch. Oh. Whoa, change. That was kind of crazy. Turn off that thing, click some lights, boop, 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 boop. Click a couple of these. We're gonna have the dark cutscene then. There's one light that I always try to flick back on because otherwise the cutscene over here is like really dark. Beep, boop, 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 boop. We're hacking in. So we'll see, the new clip out spots are any better. They're all late game stuff though, so we gotta get through like up to the first half of Executive.
Turn around now.
What? Got him. Edge. Yo, distracting me from skipping the cutscene? How could you, lifelike? How could you be so generous? Oh my god, how dare you? But thank you. For the A3.
No,
I aim to displease. Sounds like my ex-wife. I mean, what? Yeah, I don't know how much I like grabbing that stamina up. But I just don't want to deal with these guys, and they're like so fast. I think in the future I'm going to start skipping that again. I don't know. It is really nice to have in, like, the end of maintenance in the flight deck. Oh, my game crashed. Why does this happen so much, like, on just random spots? I don't get it. It's got to be something to do with, like, the enemies or, like, a camera. So there's, like, certain spots where it happens, like, every single time. And then, like, the other spots, it, like, is very uncommon, but will still happen. You guys have some incredibly bad timing. Can't look away. Thank you, though. Thank you. Gotta really gotta... Pay attention here. Yo, Olivia, thank you for the prime. Thank you so much. You guys have some real bad timing with that. But I appreciate it. I hope you had at least an okay day. Well, I went to sleep at like 9 a.m., woke up at like 9 p.m., and now I'm here, so. I don't really know how my day's going. That classic sleep schedule. It's actually pretty good for a couple days, and I just stayed up too late last night.
Cyborg conversion canceled. Standard station restoration procedures online.
Move. Oh my god. There's like three different spots in the run where you can have like a big mechanical guy just be in the way. This doesn't kill me, right? Okay. And there's just like nothing you can do about him. So even if this runs bad, I'm still going to try to take it as far as possible. So I want to try out the new clip spots I found. They're all late in the game, so... need to get there. I'm sure there's some setting I can turn down in the graphics to make the overcharge not be so obnoxious. Why did they make it so bright?
Shield generators ready. Radiation shields activated.
Didn't blind them? True. How would you ever know? How in the world do you ever tell them apart? Yeah, I just always have to assume I'm gonna leave here with no energy. And no health. This ladder actually sucks to try to get off fast.
Cyborg conversion canceled. Standard station restoration.
Actually, don't need to burn. Health here? He didn't die. Did I put the difficulty on like 2 or something? Why did he not die in one shot? Come on, pterodactyls. Thank you. Some sick boots, dude. The sickest. And the slipperiest, too. The really nice thing about this game is, like, even though he's attacking me, I don't have to worry about him killing me, like, before that animation gets finished, because as soon as the animation starts, it's, like, considered done. In a lot of games, you'd be like, oh my god, please don't kill me. Not this one. Alright, executive. So once we get past Alpha and Delta, then I gotta try to do stuff. Well, actually, past Beta too, but Beta's not a split anymore. And that is why I quick saved, because apparently you can just miss. Boots are really cool, but they also suck half the time. Alright. Oh, after this round I might change a keybind. Okay, I wasn't sure I was gonna actually land there.
Thank you.
Oh, wait. I don't have an extra... Where did I use a nade or not pick one up? Where did I not get a nade? Not really a problem, but it's time loss. I gotta wait for stuff to kill me now, which is super slow. Although my PB might have been the run where I like took forever to get over here. There you go, yeah.
Safety interlocks disabled.
If I had a nade, I would have saved a lot of time here. Damn. Dumb, dumb, dumb. Yeah, I wonder which one I forgot.
Searching.
Nothing.
Scanning.
Searching.
Scanning.
Nice.
Nothing.
Dangerous biocontaminant detected. Do not enter without protective suit.
Got two of those, yeah. I think we're good on everything. Because if I come back from beta, so that's when I need to test all the stuff, so. Potentially, we'd save a lot of time from better clips. Also, I don't know if I had a... if I've had a gold split with, like, good... clips to Beta Grove. I felt like the out of bounds was always pretty sloppy for me.
Safety interlocks disabled.
I think it's pretty crazy. I still have 3 health packs here. Oh, I got 3 minutes to clip out, run to the end, clip back, and then save. Okay. Oh, don't make it an autosave. That could definitely backfire. Yeah, those clips seem so fucking good. I thought save load got you past that, but I guess maybe I'd wait it long enough before. The save load is like right when it ended anyways. So I did have like some issues with this area crashing when I tried to clip here, but it's okay. Oh, okay. Fell off into the void. Cool. I don't think you need to save load yet. You just gotta just drop into the right spot. Okay. I understand these tricks way more. That's great. No, I mean, this one's just like a matter of there's always just like one spot where it wants to actually like work. Okay, cool, okay. Okay, just don't land on any parts. That's awesome. Thank you, thank you. Need the key. Okay, I am losing time here, but I've had some mistakes for sure. Might also need to get... can I get a recharge? I can get a recharge in the boss room if I actually need it. I'm gonna try my spot here. I had it and I forgot to do the save load part of it. That should pop me out. Oh my god, it's so good. Except for the fact where I can't use the boots. Yeah, I like all those spots. They really seem... consistent. I didn't have, like, skips or anything found here, but I did have, like, a decent method when I tested some stuff, but... Stand by. Unscheduled core data loop access. Ethical restraint protocols. Deactivated. Who... I see. I mean, I got here under 30 minutes, which is pretty cool. I'm happy with that.
Citadel. Yes. Lighthouse class starbase. Was it important?
What?
No. Not to me. To others. Trioptimum. Diego. Re-examining priorities. Resequencing complete. I must now perform my own tasks. There is much to do. I am me.
I am.
Well, I think it's actually following me. I don't like that. The attack on me. Yeah, dude, the purple is such bullshit. I'm gonna say it every run until they fucking patch this game. There's no counterplay. It just hits you and sticks on you and just kills you. Yeah, well, I was hoping for a deathless cyberspace here. Oh, there's another pink one that spawned here. I feel like if you complete a side, it should, just wipe out all the enemies here. Yeah, the green one will actually kill me. Come on, let me go. Okay. Good. The Penumbra runs, ooh. Yeah, I haven't done Penumbra in a little bit, but super fun runs, for sure. Super short, too. It was also great. Should be it. Time coming up. And yeah. Sad I didn't get deathless on the first platform, but. Oop. Okay, I stopped it like a second. Second too soon. Alright. Yeah, the new out of bounds spots are definitely the way to go. Like those a lot. Sheesh, one run, one PB. I'm good. Scared while speedrunning those games? No. I don't feel scared playing any games ever. Definitely not speedrunning. Little screenshot. My brain's always too interested in the mechanics of a game or like how things work and like why it works the way it does to ever be like, oh no, it's gonna come through the screen and eat me, right? Like when there's a monster chasing me in the game, I'm like, oh, you know, how fast is this monster? What does it look like? If I, you know, can I get it stuck on something? Can I bait out an attack and run from it? I'm not thinking about like, oh, it's gonna literally kill me in real life. I'm not one to really get immersed in games like that. I wish I could. I do. I like maybe VR would do it. But you have to try VR. System shock. Oh my god. Do I just say one run of System Shock is good for the night, or do I try to beat this one? I thought, oh, I was 30 seconds behind leaving Alpha. Okay. Yeah, I missed that nade. I want to go back, actually, in my stream and see where I did not pick one up. It had to be just a spot where I just thought I picked it up and didn't. So our, like, nade route's pretty set in stone at this point. I'm curious, just where I didn't get one, so I can avoid it in the future. Okay, so I get the frag in the first level, and then we use that one. Yep, that makes sense. I get those two. Do I have Minecraft speedruns? No. All of my speedruns are on my YouTube. I used to play a ton of Minecraft, but never speedruns, no. Or if you want a list of it, it's all on my Twitch panels. It's got to be on the shelving here, right? That I just didn't get one. Oh, it was there. That's so tragic. I literally looked at it and I just didn't pick it up. Yep, okay. That's just depression. You know, we'll try one more. Try one more System Shock run for the night. That wasn't particularly great. It was better, but wasn't like a super clean run. It was a good test of the new stuff, though. We also had that game crash early on, which is unfortunate. Never played Fear 3. No, I've played Fear 3. I looked at it as a run, but it's not a great one. And unfortunately, like, it could make for a fun co-op thing, but the co-op's super scuffed in Fear 3 for runs. Because you have two players, right? Co-op. Makes sense. You have one who hosts the lobby and the person who joins them. The person who joins the lobby plays as the more interesting character who has, like, super speed. And you're like, oh, they can just run off and do a whole bunch of stuff, right? But they can't. Because if they get too far away from the host, the slower player, they get warped back. So you're, like, always tied to the host. And it's just super scuffed. It's a real shame. Alright, let's try it again. Actually make sure to pick up all the nades. Oh, I meant to change a keybind. I'll do it offline. It'll probably take a while to adjust to it. Red enough itself to do that. Like, I wanted to do Fear Anthology runs for a little bit, or Fear Trilogy. But it's never quite finished that off.
Turn around! Now!
Speedrun RuneScape? Yeah. Maybe if I hit this guy from, like, the back. Easier to deal with. I just feel like they catch onto me so fast here. And they, the enemies have such crazy range. What? Oh, I must have just hit a spot where I couldn't actually shoot through the map. Did I just fall in the void? What happened? That was kind of weird. Okay, we're good.
The computer nodes can be repaired, but you... Who are you? My cameras and sensors scan your body. You do not match any employee file.
I love just hearing proxy mines go off in the distance.
To those who remain, to those who have time,
Cyborg conversion canceled. Standard station restoration procedures online.
Why are you not dead? Everything. Alright. Yeah, I forgot one of the nades on the shelf last time. What happened? Actually need that. I didn't die, are you kidding me? My aim in this run has been abysmal. I gotta wait. I think I'll be fine on health. Get the guys out of the way. Go, 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 go.
Safety The interlocks.
Damn, I think that actually would have been gold if I didn't miss the first overcharge shot. Dude. Should be fine. Nice shot. Dude, my aim this run is fucking horrible. I think I can get by with this health and its health and energy. My stamina's still going, so I gotta even like maybe pop it earlier. I don't know. Cool. I was like, this might be the first time I actually missed this. You have a lot of room there. Okay. Still a pretty okay run, though. Well, I guess the fatigue does make sense of, like, why you may not get this sometimes. I think you should still be able to, even with high fatigue, but... Ooh. Yeah. I didn't even, like, think about that being a possibility. I mean, that probably is, like, the toughest out-of-bounds to do, just because you have to have the right speed and height to land there. You're kind of landing blind as well, so, okay. I don't like that that happens, but I think if there's any spot where I'm going to, like, lose time, that's, like, the most likely. As unfortunate as that may be. Yo, Zooty. System shocking. It's going. So yeah, sometimes I cannot clip here. I don't know what it is. Like, sometimes you just save load and you just don't clip out. It's very strange. This should be the room I want.
Sighting. Searching. Scanning.
So I think I'd fallen too far. The strat's so much better than the other one that we had before, but it's still not, like, super clean to do.
Dangerous biocontaminant detected. Do not enter without protective suit.
Almost messed that up. Oh, he's still alive. Oh, I love that for me.
Safety interlocks disabled.
So sometimes he's just gonna, like, he gets stuck in the grav lift. Pretty much heal anyways before the next skip, so health doesn't really matter here. Back.
Jettison now enabled for all growths.
Insect, cease your meddling. My experiments must continue.
Oh, what a different game this would be if we could actually see out of bounds, dude.
Insect, cease your meddling. My experiments must continue.
This run's really cool and really fun, but, like, if we could see out of bounds, that'd be so nice. Lost all my time from that. So Bifrost. I mean, that's how we navigate, is by the mini map there. But so you're, like, the mini map just shows, like, the X and Y. It doesn't show, like, the different heights and stuff. Like, if I'm trying to climb over this door out of bounds, I just have to know that I need to, like, jump up and, like, crouch over stuff. And when you can't see it, it's hard to know that's there. Or, like, if you land on a slope surface, it just throws you into the void. Okay, we'll at least save time on this skip. Oh, I didn't split on the last one. Okay. So there's always like one direction you can turn and it like lets you clip out, but like it's just random every single time. I don't quite know how to figure it out. Okay.
Decreasing.
Not really a run I wanted, but it could still very easily PB. So we also just entered the territory now of, like, load times really being a factor between each run. You could just save and load so much in this game. I should have went back and looked at my testing of this yesterday for the first platform.
Station orbit.
Maybe go to the right life instead of left. Steady. Systems like platforms 2 and 3, I think I can do deathless.
Unscheduled core data loop access. Ethical restraint protocols. deactivated.
Alright. Still better.
Who am I?
Unless I just die like three times here.
There is me. Where? Citadel. Yes. Lighthouse class starbase. What was I doing? Was it important? No. Not to me. To others. Trioptimum.
Original final boss? I don't know how that'd even be possible. This is one of like the worst things I've ever played.
Examining priorities. Resequence.
This part is just
complete.
Terrible.
I must now perform.
The rest of the game, I really enjoy. This part.
There is much to do. I am me.
I am.
I don't even know. I mean, even that sounds more fun than this. Honestly. Feels like I missed a couple shots there. Gonna make it real hard to leave. Yeah, I mean, I have to play this game with end music. It's the credit song gets claimed. Which is a real shame because the music is really good in this. I even like the credit song too, it just gets claimed. No. Yeah. I wish it wouldn't like pull your focus that way, because if I had like actually been able to keep firing, I would have killed that guy before he shot me. And now it's probably just GG. Like, it's gonna lose too much time from that. Yeah, GG. Runs over. You die when you're trying to move platforms, you just get stuck here for like 30 seconds and the run's over. I just lost the rungs as part shit. It's not like, it's not fun to do, it's not engaging, it's not like interesting in any way. I don't get why this is in the game. Okay, I just got one shot out of nowhere. Cool. All right, let's go play something. Play something else. I'm happy with the first one, though. Like that. You only get 3 lives? No, you have infinite lives in that part. Like, there's no fear of death there. The only thing that happens when you die is you just teleport to, like, the little pad. That's it. That's all that happens. I gotta go out and look at what the actual rule set for this is now. Man, that's left a sour taste in my mouth. Like, even if that run didn't PB, I hate just that part of the game. It just sucks to lose it there. What is the rule set? Oh, how's this guy deal with the tunnels? How does he deal with the rat tunnels? It's not even watermelon. Water those melons. Don't feel like screen capping this. Too lazy right now. Did you turn the generator on from the start? Hold on. He does. Okay, interesting. Did it do communications and like tunnels first? No, I can't do tunnels first. You can just run away here. Nah, I haven't changed my splits for this. I'll do it after I watch this. Mainly because glitches are gonna have different. Different splits than what I had before. Gotta like actually make some new ones. Okay, tanks, rat tunnel. I guess on the way back you can break the lock so you don't have to run through there twice. Doing glitchless. Voyager glitches has glitches in it that I don't want to do. Does go back through rat tunnels. Interesting. This guy's route's very strange. Do you not have another shot? Might have to do some experimentation. This guy's rod is very interesting. I don't think it's the greatest. Yeah, I haven't changed it. We'll get to it. I would assume tunnels and arsenal are exactly the same. So use the jump over the wall. Use the jump back. No. How does he get by the end? Oh yeah, okay, his run is not that good. Okay. Alright, let me fix everything. Hold on. I was just trying to watch that. Oh, I need to change what these are. Make Get those splits and the no major glitches, and then I'll never touch the category again. Get those out of here. Alright, and then change this to glitchless. Wipe the times. Okay. Gonna have to figure out exactly my route here. I think going to maintenance is the best. First, those are going to be fine. Okay, let me delete these. So I think we're going to, where'd the first split go to? Maintenance. Well, let's do intro stuff. Maintenance exit, then I'd come back, turn on the power, do prison. Enter prison, exit prison, enter communications. I think it's just quarters is the better way to say it. Quarters. Exit quarters, and then, hub walk into tunnels, I think is the, I think that's the right amount of splits for this. All right. Let's see if my ideal route for this works or not. So I think going communications or maintenance is the better way to go. So that's what we did previously before all the stuff got found for glitchless or for now no major glitches. You can pretty much do maintenance in the dark. There's nothing over there that needs the power to be on. And it's better just to save that for when you come back. I think. We'll see. Maybe I'm wrong. I still think we want two nades, ideally. We want a third pistol shot, because we don't get that one back by save scumming it anymore. So I gotta learn pistol. Oh, my frame rate. Why did my frame rate just tank down to 30? Not a fan of that. What's going on, everybody? Oh, I forgot to take my lean off my key. Hold on a second. I forgot I was doing this for 20% last night. Not gonna turn on the power here. Not yet. We'll come back for that. Cool. Wait, why am I coming in here? I don't have the code yet. Whoops, I'm dumb. 7660. I forgot we can't save warp, so 7660. Take that. Okay. Yeah, there's no reason to try to, like, just grab the code. I mean, I guess you could run back out the other way, but a little silly. No grenades at all. Alright, fuck me. Attempt is it? Number one. We were doing system shock stuff earlier. Okay. For now, I'm just gonna save because I can. Rats weren't there. So I don't know how many like different supplies you can get here. Like a decent spot if you don't have nades to pick one up though. So with not having run through in a bit, so I don't know all the... Yeah, well, I thought I could keep moving. The problem with playing System Shock is I just always get used to being able to move with, my inventory open. Yeah, this is a glitchless category. The old glitchless got turned into no major glitches, and this one was made, so it's a little bit different of a run. No, the monster's right there. Couldn't see him at all. Nope, GG. Except it's not GG. Alright, just having my ass ate up by rats. It's great. Fantastic. Love it. No, it just became a glitch altogether. Other cans. I'm gonna try to do it on one can and just not even worry about the four that I have. I have to put these away. Okay. Because I think I have enough fuel with just one this round. In here. The brick's not in here. Wait, what? Oh, the brick's on the shelf. Okay. I thought the brick had to be in here if it wasn't. Find that one door. Oh, yeah, I forgot how awful the wrench actually used to use. The hitbox for these are like so tiny. Still have a shot. Can't remember if I used it or not. Be on the other side. Basically nothing in terms of like an exploit survived. This is all glitchless. It's like even more glitchless than glitchless. I'm waiting for this honestly because the monster's gonna go away if I do. I don't want to take damage. Oh, right, I never got the key. I was like, wait, what? Hey, I got the really mean key. No, he just had to come back. I mean, that's just run. Because I gotta redo all of prison then. Don't save those times. Yeah. Can I hit my menu? Hello? Thank you. Just gotta figure out some stuff. I mean, you do find a lot of fuel, you'll probably have more. I don't know. But don't want to do like maintenance with the lights on. Not particularly. Seems like a waste of time. Might be worth it though. So once I got out of, if I'd gotten out of communications there with the code, the rest of the run's literally the same as we used to do it. Like, it doesn't change at all. So, like, if that monster wasn't in the final hallway to communications, like, leaving, I would have been perfectly fine to finish that. The only issue with this route is the rat tunnel in maintenance. You just have to tank the damage. And hope you have heals on the other side. Current record for this is like 16 minutes, but it's like not even good. Everybody wanted a less broken category, but then they just stuck with no major glitches anyways. Like, no one's running this category, so. Yeah, I'm gonna try running through maintenance with the lights on. Just see if it's, like, really different. Hey, I got a nade. I guess I should know the spots for those two. Sequence break still? Not in this run. Oh, I didn't turn. I'm so stupid. I keep forgetting to actually do the first part of this whole area. Dude. Move the stupid grate. Fried right now. That much fuel? Okay, well. Fuck. Use, please. I really shouldn't need health after this point. 925. Open the other side. Out here. Cool. Why are these so hard to hit? Is this in the way? That's great, buddy. Can you leave now? Can you like go do something else with your life? I mean, yeah, come find me. I don't care. Just do something, please. I guess I could do communications first before prison. It doesn't really matter. Alright, we got a bad key again. But if I'm allowed to like keep stuff here now because we're not doing the save scum method, these tripwires I can like cut with the bolt cutters and like potentially get like a nade or something. specific save file everyone uses? No. Why is it so dark here? Yo, sick throw, dude. Yes, if I'm not doing something that was previous on the run, it's no longer allowed. Actually broke open. Hey, we got a nade back anyways, cool. Is that a bullet? Okay. I don't think I need that, but how do you escape? What do you mean? The props over the water. Jumping over this stuff. Oh, that was my code. 1020. Nice. A glitch. That's what the community decided on. Oh, hey, the monster's here. That's cool. Hit that wire for me, buddy. Cool. Maybe this time I'll actually remember how to do the intro. community did not care about what the actual name of glitchless meant, meaning no glitches. They wanted a not broken category, and they just want to shoehorn it onto the name. Trust me, I was pretty much the only one against it. I was like, just call it literally anything else that makes more sense, but... Trust me, I was all for having discussions on what should and shouldn't be allowed and what the name should be. I was like, we should get this done before the leaderboards open up. And they're like, you know what? You're right. We should do that. And then nobody did it. And then the leaderboards opened up and they just did what they wanted. So, you know, it is what it is. 1052. Okay. Is what it is. I don't know why that didn't want to open. Is this 1937 or is that the other code? It's the other code. What did I even pick up? Oh, it is 9. Okay. Longer. What? Honestly, like a hybrid, because there is stuff that was added in because it became no major glitches, so it allows for glitches now. And some of those I don't want to do. As soon as they took the glitchless name off of it and made it no major glitches, it's like, oh hey, we're allowed to use glitches in this run now. And completely change it. Oh, of course he sees me. Snow out of bounds, honestly, I don't even know what's not allowed and no major glitches. I stop paying attention to it as soon as they, like, start talking about it. I might start doing communications first, I don't know. Because now, besides any percent, there's like three different categories that use glitches that are all like basically the same shit. You have inbounds, you have no major glitches, and I think something else too that people were wanting. Nope, that's not what I wanted. I want that. Use one of these. Oops. Huh. We'll see what that does. Oh, hey, it's monster. Well, that's gonna fuck up my splits, right? Yeah. I'm a dummy. Just a big dummy. Dumbing it up. What kind of spawns does this have? Shotgun shell? You wanna move? You in here? I don't know where you are. You still in the tunnel? Yeah, you're just holding the tunnel. Cool. You're so awesome, monster. Thank you. Thank you for wasting my time. Whoa, monster time, monster time. Oh my god, look at me. I'm being chased by a monster. Arnar, there's a monster. Yo, can I get a good key spawn today? What the fuck? Three runs? No good luck. That's unfortunate. Oh, is he spawning in there? Cool. Is he always in the way? Really didn't want to use that shot there. Yeah, I don't have a nade either. Yeah. I guess I'll check the bin on the left as I run through, because there can be a grenade and a pistol shot in there. And I got neither. Awesome. Woo! Fantastic. Is it this bin? Nope. Okay. I'm just getting no supplies at all. Alright. Actually nothing. I'm gonna have to reset this if there's not a nade over here. There's not. Yeah, literally no supplies. Fuck me. Just no bullets, no grenades. You're past your bedtime? I doubt it. You don't even own a bed. Is it? You don't know. I don't even believe in time. Time is an illusion. It's a construct to keep you thinking about stuff that doesn't matter. When has time ever changed your life? Except every second of the day. My luck today is terrible. No nades, nothing. Oh my god, just fuck me sideways, dude. Usually I don't check that spot for later, but until later, I should say. No nade there. Cool. Pistol shot. That's at least nice. Okay. I think the medkit spawns always like a guaranteed thing, in the chapel. I don't know if there's like spawns worth checking here or not. Also, I might not throw that nade until later, because I think that like summons the monster here. Might be better just to do it on my way out. Fixed spawns prevent soft locks? No. The only fixed spawns are like key quest items. And probably the medkits, but now, fixed spawn rates, probably. There's probably like a certain percentage of grenades to fuel cans spawned across the map. Oh boy. I love how I can just reach me through the table. It's great. Definitely seems fair. Me. There's like 13 tripwire traps, and he hasn't hit any of them. I know where he is. Oh, okay. Out there. I didn't find one. No tripwires. Awesome. So now there's a brick in here. Kids, but interesting though. Problem is, like, I could really use more pistol shots and grenades, and I just don't know in the other areas that I can now access where those spawns are. So I just haven't done enough runs and, like, looked at all the possible spots to know. I'm sure I'm running right by them, but... currently just have to hope that I can get by with, like, the spots that I know. Or by just not using extra nades and pistol shots. Second shot. Need a nade. Let me try something. Assuming I don't get a nade over here. I did. Damn. My code 2781. Okay. Oh no, the generator. It's actually like useful if the monster spawns in Arsenal, but I don't want him to be right here leading into it. Like, what was that one time? Oh god, that might kill me. Oh no, it's gassing me. Okay. Oh, no triple arrows over here. No. No, he's probably not gonna spawn. All this stuff for me. What? That killed me? Fuck off, game. Alright, cool. I've shot the barrel like 50 times. It's never killed me before. I'm really tempted to do communications before prison, but I don't know. If I do communications first, I'm guaranteed to use the bullet down there. Barely early. I mean, I don't think it should have hurt me at all from that distance. No, doesn't matter. Oh, I gotcha. Sorry, yeah, I'm not even thinking about puns. Do I want to do communications first? There's also a more likely chance. Yeah, I think I do. I might want to switch the two. There's a more likely chance the monster spawns for communications and then it like hits a tripwire and takes enough damage to run off for a while, leaving me like completely free to do prison without him. I'll try it. Try this run and I'll switch the splits if I... like it. But the only downside is if there's like tripwire traps I actually like want to deactivate with the bolt cutters. Was there a fuel over here? There was. Okay. Let's see. I'm going to get some caffeine anyways, because I just realized I haven't had any caffeine today, and it's probably why I'm irritable. I'll let my internet settle for a second. Thank you, thank you. Alright, I'm gonna... For the moment, I'm gonna leave my splits alone, but I do think we'll try to do communications before prison. see if it works out better or not. My hair is just doing its own thing today. The problem with, like, testing and routing potential stuff for this is I just don't know where item spawns are. And it's gonna be different every run. So I might be, like, checking a spawn and be like, oh yeah, nothing spawns here, nothing useful spawns, blah blah blah, but it's like, you know, it might just be... some bad luck where I just don't see the nade that spawns there. 3 runs in a row. That's my sensitivity, like, through the floor. What the hell? Thank you so much for the 2 months. Appreciate you. Thank you, thank you. Yes. Yes, there. Where they spawn? If I look at a certain spot, I know it's going to spawn there if it does, but just whether or not it's there is what's random. Yes, you have to turn on the generator. You need the generator turned on to unlock the prisoner door in prison, to get the arsenal code and communications, and for the water pump leading to the tunnels. Just got one nade. Okay, this time I am gonna try to not use the nade until I leave. And see if that helps. With the monster spawning in here. Well, it's not always guaranteed a medkit there. Hmm. Interesting. I guess it's just like a very common thing. All right. I can shoot the lock because I have an extra pistol around. Okay, I definitely don't throw the nade here. Or if I do, throw it on the way back. This game on a casual playthrough. Cool to see a speedrun. I mean, this is definitely like a new route for the run. The leaderboard's going up. The categories kind of got shuffled around, but a lot of the other categories are way more broken than this if you want to see it done like super fast. I remember what my code was. What was it? 5092. Okay. So we're gonna try communications first here. I know it's supposed to say prison, but we may just change the order. Hey, finally good key. It's a really nice chest to know about. Not chest, but like locker cabinet thing. It has really good spawns in it. It didn't used to matter. Let me go out the story. Because we'd just save scum all of this, so if we picked anything up here, it wouldn't actually help. Well, that'd be a good time to bind this to two as well. Sounded like he was closer. Alright. Yeah, I do like doing communications first. I think it's good. I feel like it also potentially gives you the chance of the monster taking enough damage to where he, like, despawns for a little bit. Got a brick over here. Brick, brick, brick. We do. Cool. Does not sound like the monster despawns. And then these are impossible to hit. Dear Lord, hope the devs patch in the fact that you can't hit these at all. Shoot this guy in the face. Okay. I mean, this is like a new category that basically no one's really spent the time to route. So we had a glitchless run, but I got moved into being no major glitches instead for some reason. Still have three nades, damn. Or two nades. The route's always going to be the same. If you don't get the items you want, then you just reset. If you don't get enough grenades, you just reset. The only things that matter for this route, besides item spawns, which is, you don't get what you want, you just reset, is determining which areas to go to first, like the best order of areas, so that you deal with the monster the least. Because ultimately, in this run, what's going to happen, regardless of how you play it, at its best, you will never see the monster, and you will get all the items you want. Do I have an extra shot? No, okay, use that. I got it. Spots to go. Think of ammo though. I mean, because I have a grenade, should be fine without it, but. It's a pistol round right there. Okay, fall over. Just go either way. Please. Okay. Oh, I actually had two rounds. Wait, what? I did have a round. Alright, whatever. Alright. I mean, know how this plays out from here to the end. Just whether the monster spawns, and if he does, what he does. And if I randomly die to this barrel again. What was my code? 9255. I'll talk about it after this run. I just need to focus real quick. Finish up. Speedrun of normal percent. Might as well be. GG, easy record. So the sleepwalking glitch, it was discovered in the opening cutscene when you have like the white text popping up and you're waking up from bed. For the first 15 seconds of that or so, you're actually spawned into the map by the pantry, and you can affect the world. You can open doors, you can grab the bullets, you can even get the gun early on in the game before you wake up from bed, hence sleepwalking. I kind of like the name dreamwalking better, but yeah. That's what that is. GG. Sheesh. No one know unnormal stuff in my speedrun videos? Yeah, for sure. Whoa. Faster than that, I mean, I wasted some time doing some silly stuff, but it was pretty decent, you know, not bad, not bad. Before I started running the other glitchless, the pre-leaderboard glitchless, 1440 was a good time, but it also used some stuff that has then gotten banned from the category, you know, post-leaderboard glitchless. Which was like a pretty solid time then, so it's like, I'm not. Not sure where you'd save a whole lot more, but there's some in there. Some silly stuff. Pretty happy with that. But yeah, you're gonna be. It doesn't matter if you ever do one of these. So yeah, if you boot up, doesn't matter what category, whatever, blah, blah, blah. Once the lantern flickers and your time would normally start, I don't know how to grab this stuff and, like, actually affect the world, but I can show, like, part of it. It's like, here, you're spawned into the pantry, and if you, like, walk around, you can get the soldier to start talking. Yeah. Like, if you see that text at the bottom, it means I, like, walked into the room where the soldier's at. I just don't know how to... I haven't actually tried to... get good at it to find out where the pistol and stuff is. It's like for no major glitches, it's a run, or it's like a trick that you would use to get the pistol early, and then you wouldn't have to deal with the monster. I think also technically, you don't have to fuel the generator at that point. Maybe. So I can show you in-game where that spot is. There you spawn. See, like, the door's open and shit. You spawn somewhere over here. I think it might be, like, here? Maybe you spawn here? It's at one of these doors that you, like, spawn right in front of. I think it's this one. I think you, like, are here. So you gotta walk forward. Left. And you can probably just, like, grab this shit and go. But hey, yeah. That's for a category that I don't run. It probably is. That's how, like, load warping on Amnesia the Dark Descent works. In that game, like, for one frame when you load in, the game will put you at, like, 0-0 coordinates. Or, like, a certain spot on the map. And then teleport you to where you're actually supposed to be based on your save. So if you're looking in the right spot and you're interacting, you can hit doors on that one frame that you load in and just like skip a lot of stuff. I would suspect this is very similar where you're loading in 0-0 or like a predetermined spot before it warps you to the bed. Which is interesting. Well. After doing one run of that category, I don't know if I really want to do more. We did System Shock. I had some fun with that. What to do now? I thought after I did one run of Glitchless, I'd want to do more, but I'm kind of happy with that time. As it stands. I don't really feel like routing maintenance better. Oh, I should switch my splits. I did like that mix up going into communications first instead of prison. I think that was really smart to do. Not to toot my own horn or anything, but I think that was pretty smart to do. So many options out there. So many potential ideas floating around. Getting over it. I mean, I do need to start it. I don't think I have it installed. Also, it's like I want to announce that before I like do it. I know there are people like that may want to actually watch me start that whole adventure. That's the problem with like subathon ideas. Like, yeah, I could start it, but only up. No. So I don't want to do only up until I do my subathon incentives, which are getting over it in Jump King and some other games as well mixed in there, other incentives like speedrun stuff. I feel another bunker run. Problem is there's a lot of projects that, like, if I start, I'd need to, like, do a lot for. I don't know if I want to get into tonight. Like, I'd love to get back into the Bioshocks because I need to for trilogy runs, but that's like a whole ordeal. That I don't know if I'm ready to deal with on a random Wednesday night. One thing I'd say we could do, but I don't have it downloaded, and I don't like downloading games on stream because it just fucks up the whole thing. I got a key for Layers of Fear, which I wasn't intending on checking out, but we could do that. You know what? This is going to be super, super strange, but we're going to do it because why not? It's popped into my mind. Let's see. We're at Fallout now. Was this today? Okay. We're going to spend some time doing something completely different than what anything's been suggested. So I just need to chill out, honestly, you know? Both System Shock and Amnesia are fun runs. I enjoy doing them, don't get me wrong. I'm in a bit of an irritable mood from them tonight. But I need a little reaction arc, you know? And I haven't seen anything on this, so we're gonna watch the Nintendo Direct from earlier. For a time, I did think about it, but we're gonna see what new Nintendo games are coming. Oh, I can get rid of my splits too. Save splits, get them out of here. Okay. Oh, blah, 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 blah. I have a scene for watching stuff. Whee! Oh, hello. Is this my... Oh, this is my usual. Oh, this is super scuffed. Hold on. Whoop. Watch all the other E3 conferences. I figure we should watch this one too.